Hello everyone, it is your financial coach Donna, and I want to welcome you back to Growing My Wealth with Donna, a place where we are changing our mindset about money and increasing our wealth. You know, I always like to start my video with a question. Today's question is, do you know how to protect yourself from identity theft or what to do if you suspect your identity has been compromised? Let's see how knowledgeable you are. First, let's define identity theft. According to Experian.com, identity theft is a type of crime where someone's personal and financial data is obtained and used without their permission. Identity thieves may use a person's information to do things like apply for a credit card or loan in their name, raid their bank account, or use their credit card, file a fraudulent tax return or health insurance claim, or simply sell your information to a third party. In 2020, identity theft cases doubled in the United States, mainly due to cyber criminals taking advantage of people affected economically by COVID-19 who filed to receive government benefits. The Federal Trade Commission advises consumers to be cautious of cyber criminals exploiting coronavirus fears to steal personally identifiable information, PII. Financial information and medical information are especially sensitive right now. For these reasons, it is imperative that you know how to protect yourself from identity theft. Today, I'm going to share with you ways to reduce your risk of identity theft. Before I get started, I want to share a story about a friend applying for her employer identification number, EIN, to start her own business. How exciting, right? She went online to apply for her EIN, but did not realize that she keyed in her personal information on a fake IRS website. She became suspicious when the site asked for her credit card information to pay for her EIN. She knew there was no charge for EIN, so she did not proceed. Be aware that there are fake websites. She called me in a panic mode. After calming her down, I gave her instructions on what to do. She contacted one of the three credit bureaus, Equifax, Experian, and TransUnion, and placed a fraud alert on her credit report. A fraud alert is a notice placed on your credit report that alerts creditors and credit bureaus that you may be a victim of identity theft or fraud. Think of it as a red flag to potential lenders and creditors. This is one action that you can employ to help reduce your risk of identity theft. Now, let's talk about the other ways to protect yourself. First, you must recognize the signs of identity theft, such as no longer receiving your household bills in the mail, you've been turned down for a loan or credit card, being billed for items you did not purchase, charges you do not recognize, tax return rejected, small charges on your credit card statement, or a call from your credit card company informing you of suspicious activity on your account. These are signs that fraud is developing or already happening. You must contact your creditor immediately so action can be taken quickly if you suspect your identity has been compromised. Second, protect yourself from identity theft. There are 8 steps to start this process. First, use Password Protect on your devices, such as your mobile phone. We use our mobile device to check email and bank accounts. We definitely use them for social media. According to Kaspersky Labs, about 52% of Americans do not password protect their mobile devices. Not having a password on your smartphone or tablet is like leaving your home with the door wide open. If your device falls into the wrong hands, your email, bank accounts, and other private data can be easily accessible. So please password protect your mobile devices. Next, you may want to consider using a password manager. Every day we use passwords to log into our accounts. Some of us use the same password for every single account because it's easier. However, it is not a good idea and it is a major security risk. It is best to mix up passwords and use a unique, strong password for every account. Do not include your name nor birthday in any of your passwords. Also, change your password often. Now, I know it is impossible to remember every single password. As I said earlier, You may want to use a password manager. People have mixed reviews about using one because there are some degree of vulnerability to consider. But a password manager securely stores your account information without requiring you to remember all of your login credentials. A password manager is like a warehouse for passwords and a security guard for your personal data. Another way to protect yourself from identity theft is to watch out for phishing attempts. Do not click on any suspicious looking links in your emails or text messages. Identity thieves use emails and websites that look like they are coming from your bank, credit card company, mortgage lender, or other financial institutions to trick you into entering your account information or other private data. Check with your financial institution before clicking on any link and never download an email attachment unless you know what it is. Also, never give out personal information over the phone. Identity thieves will also pose as a bank or credit card company employee over the phone. Remember, no legitimate organization will call or ask you for your personal information, such as your bank or credit card PIN number or social security number. If you suspect that the call is not legitimate, hang up and contact the organization using the phone number on your statement. Lastly, the IRS will never contact via phone. Typically, the IRS will send taxpayer requests and information via mail. Checking your credit report regularly is another way to protect yourself from identity theft. By checking regularly, you can spot any discrepancies early, take action quickly, and stop the situation from getting worse. Remember, you can get a free credit report yearly from each of the three credit bureaus by visiting annualcreditreport.com. Also, protect your personal documents. Physical documents can present a security risk since some paperwork includes your social security number or bank information. There are a few ways to protect yourself, such as limiting how much sensitive paper mail you receive, avoid leaving your mail in your mailbox, and shred your ATM credit card receipts and other physical private records and statements that include any personal and financial data. Lastly, do not carry many credit cards in your wallet. This will minimize the impact if your wallet or purse is stolen. Most importantly, do not carry your Social Security card on your person. This is an identity thief's gateway to more financial accounts. You must protect your Social Security number at all costs. If you ever believe that you are a victim of identity theft, review your credit report regardless of the fraud. Also, file an identity theft report if needed. This includes reporting to the Federal Trade Commission at identitytheft.com and possibly filing a police report. You may also want to reach out to your creditors to explain the situation. In addition, place a fraud alert or security freeze with the credit bureau. Lastly, dispute any inaccurate information you find on your credit report. Disputes are generally resolved within 30 days and the fraudulent information will be removed if the credit bureau confirms your claim. In closing, always be vigilant with your identity fraud protection. If you take steps to protect your information and identity, you will make yourself a more difficult target for thieves and may even stop them in their tracks. As always, thank you so much for watching. Please click like, share, and leave a comment and subscribe below. Have a wonderful day.